So wherever you go in Jamaica, you are surrounded by art in its many forms. But have you taken a close look at the street art of Rastafari, his imperial majesty, and wondered about the use and significance of images of his majesty and his empress? Well, Dr. Anna Perkins, senior program officer at UMONA and doctor of theological ethics, has, and she joins us now via Zoom to give us the details. Morning, ma'am. Welcome to Smile Jamaica. It's morning time.
Hey, Neville. Good morning. Thanks for having me.
Good morning.
It is our pleasure, and the great Prince Son is here with us.
I bow to that member of the family.
You don't have to. I was reading this, and you said, having said what I said, one unexpected but recurring representation of Rastafari that you found was the divine duo, King Alpha and Queen Omega, Emperor Haile Selassie and the Royal Empress Menin. Why did that surprise? Why did you find that a little strange, maybe?
Because I tended to see a lot of images of the emperor on his own. But then once I started to look a little bit more closely, I recognized that there were actually many other spaces where he was not by himself. He was with the empress. And some of the stuff that I noted that was fascinating was that every time he was with her, they were always dressed in their royal robes, these elaborate crowns and so on. And then I also noticed, Neville, that she was never by herself. In fact, I only found one instance. And of course, I haven't seen all Rasta street art in Jamaica. And most of what I looked at was focused in Kingston, yeah?
Right.
I only found one instance of her by herself. And it's one of the images that would have accompanied the Gleaner article. And I call that one Her Royal Highness Enflamed, because it's this beautiful image on a cart just by Friendship Lane down in Crossroads. And she's crowned, and there are some symbols around her that look like flames. And then there is the word I-N-R-I, which usually is the word that the four letter symbol that speaks to the presence of Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
That's exactly the one.
Yeah.
So it really is saying Jesus Christ, King of Nazareth, Jesus Christ of Nazareth, King of the Jews. And it would have been the sign that would have been Jesus's cross.
Right.
Speaks to the presence of the divine. So it being there, that four-letter reference being there tells me, or this of course is scholarly interpretation and so on, that the fullness of the Godhead, the emperor is also present by four letter symbol being there as well. So she's really not alone.
Yeah.
It's fascinating for me.
Yeah. Dr. Perkins, I don't know if you've done a lot of research on all of this, but do you think the artists themselves have this kind of thing in their head, or they just go and paint Selassie, go and paint Empress Menin and put it somewhere? Do you think they're it's a message they're sending, or they know what they're doing?
Let's face it, the artwork gives expression to the faith both of the artist and the artists, because obviously there are more than one, they're not all the same person, although I did recognize one particular artist, Bogart, whose work shows up quite a bit. So what we're looking at here on the screen right now is one of his pieces, and I find a lot of his work on the stalls and so on. So there's no doubt that it represents something of the faith of the artist, and then something of the faith of the people for whom he's making these depictions, for whom he's drawing these representations of what their faith is all about. I also think, too, that whether we like it or not, once you put out those kind of visuals, you're it's a kind of pedagogy. You're teaching something, you're saying something about what people believe. And then, of course, in putting it there, that gives an opportunity for deeper kind of reflections, and even deeper and more meanings can develop from what's been put there. So the artist may well have just simply wanted to represent the emperor, may have a special love for the empress, and put that there. I-N-R-I, I Negus rule Israel, and so on. That's part of what that means in the folk religious culture, in the Rastafari religious culture that has impacted Jamaican culture in a very significant way. In fact, in such a way that people don't even recognize it. It's so much a part of how people, the ordinary, so-called ordinary Jamaican people, understand their faith and give expression to their faith as Black people, people who are African descended. So there's what you call Neverland Archie, an excess of meaning. So it's possible that someone like myself, with the kind of interest that I have, could come along, look at what they have painted, and start to ask deeper questions, you know? So I'm fascinated, why is she there?
Yep.
What does it mean that she's there? And can we learn something more from her presence, you know? So,
You say one thing in particular in the Gleaner article that I'm really interested in. It's a critique for patriarchy. It says, representing this divine totality, beginning and end as male and female, does not necessarily translate, you say, into full respect for women in a liberty, which is often critiqued for its patriarchy and subordination of women. What do you mean exactly by that?
So what I'm pointing out is the contradiction of a lot of what we tend to profess as human beings, and we see that a lot in the religious space. There's no doubt about it. We can claim to believe, I'm a Roman Catholic theologian, obviously Jamaican, African descending, and therefore myself influenced by the impact of the Rastafari philosophy and so on. Okay, so a lot is spoken about and written about Rasta that says that Rasta does not give that kind of regard to women. So, you know, even think about how they term a woman a sister or a daughter, which subordinates them, makes them not quite fully woman. Yet at the same time, a woman like me walking down the road becomes empress. And that's a title of regard for me wearing locks and so on. So when you look at how Rasta has been developing their philosophy over time, the presence of the Alpha and the Omega, as in the male principle and the female principle, not just only in the divine emperor himself, but also present in the empress, speaks to the recognition of the value of the feminine principle. And what you want, therefore, that to be as fully translated as possible in how we live, how Rastas live. And we do know that that's not a perfect translation by any means. It's a process. People are growing. We're coming to a deeper understanding of how we ought to relate to each other. And we know that the challenge that exists in every Jamaican family space, whether they're Rasta or non-Rasta influence, will always be a challenge that speaks to how do we fully give regard to the other, particularly the female other, who can be seen, according to how some interpretations of scripture are done, to called upon to be silent, you know, not be permitted to speak, cover her head, because the man is the glory of God. We could go into all of those different ways of understanding the female and the feminine that makes her subordinate, and that runs up and rubs up against ways of understanding the female that suggests that she's as equal and as beautiful and as valid as the male, but we don't live it fully. That's the challenge.
Yes, and at the same time, there's a complete deeper appreciation for what it means to the street art. In some places, graffiti is street art. When you looked at all of this, how did that move you in terms of seeing all of this and recognizing what it meant in that kind of way?
Actually, I was fascinated by it. In fact, this piece that was published in the Gleaner, and I do have to say thanks to Amitabh Sharma from the Gleaner, who was so willing to take on this particular piece of research that I worked on, is part of a larger project of looking at religious street art in Jamaica, because we speak of and understand ourselves as Jamaicans as being particularly religious people.
Yes.
We're particularly artistic and creative people. So you are going to find that there are many ways that we give expression to the faith that we have. It's also pointing out to us how important the Bible is. That's one of my favorite pieces of street art that you've just put up there, Archie. That's coming from Mountain View Avenue. And what's fascinating for me, going back to your prior question, is the fact that God of God is accompanied by a female stick figure. How can I not ask questions about who drew that? Why was it drawn? Is the owner of that stall female? Is where I'm going with that?
Yep.
It's
yep.
fascinating to see something like that.
Yep.
So my interest in it kind of started probably 20, 25 years ago. Archie, I think you're too young. Never might remember this. There was graffiti on the external walls of St. Andrew Parish Church. You remember that?
It's all painted over.
You see, that's also part of the thing with street art. It's very ephemeral. And it's difficult to historicize, to put it in historical context, because you don't know who painted it, why it was painted, at what point, and so on. So when I do my work, I talk about it as a snapshot. It's what I'm seeing at a particular point in time. I could go back and it's not there, just as how you won't find that set of graffiti on the walls of St. Andrew Parish Church anymore. But one of the things that I remember from, and I did at the point, take photographs. So this is the time way before cell phone and cameras. So I'm so kicking myself, I can't tell you.
Dr. Perkins, I'm sorry I have to jump in.
No.
I'm sorry I have to jump in because we have to go. I would love my producer to bring you back because I also want to find out about theological ethics.
As well.
I want to find out about, but thank you.
Happy
so
to come back.
Yeah,
thank you so much for having me.
Thank you. It's our pleasure. Dr. Anna Perkins, Senior Program Officer at UA Mona and Doctor of Theological Ethics.
And still ahead, we'll tell you about multiple myeloma. And taking us to News in 5 is a 2015, it's a rewind performance, 2018 rewind performance from Jadore and the current band singing real reggae music.